judges' appointment. This is for appointment of judges of Superior Court of every province and territory, the Court of Appeal, the Federal Court of Appeal, the Federal Court, and the Tax Court of Canada. Professional competence and overall merits are the primary qualification for judicial appointment. In this respect, Judicial Advisory Committee members are provided with assessment criteria. The Commissioner for Federal Judicial Affairs has overall responsibility for the administration of the judicial appointment process on behalf of the government. One of the potential impediments to appointment is any current or past civil or criminal actions involving the candidate. Before 2014, there was an action against a person. He filed a motion to strike action against himself in January 2015. And then in February 2015, he appointment as a judge of Superior Court of Ontario, the same court that there was an action against him. In 2017, another judge from the same court and same level of him accepted his motion and dismissed the action against him. This action amounted in a sequence of wrongdoing. By law, a judge cannot make judgment in favor or against another judge of the same court and same level. All candidates who wish to be considered for federal judicial appointments must complete a questionnaire. In part 9 of this questionnaire, under personal suitability and integrity, there are questions which some of them are as follows. Question 2. Are you aware of any outstanding complaints or investigations against you? Question 5. Are you currently involved in litigation as a party or as an intervener in your personal capacity or as a part of a group? Do you foresee commencing or defending any litigation on the foreseeable future, i.e., because you have received a demand letter or otherwise have noticed of a possible claim against you, or because you are aware of a possible claim that you have against another party? Question 6. Have you previously involved in litigation as a party or intervener in your personal capacity or as a part of a group? Question 11. Is there anything in your past or present which could reflect negativity on yourself or judicial? The above said judge had to complete this questionnaire, and he probably answered no to these questions, which was a lie. Otherwise, he shouldn't appoint as a judge. It is the commissioners and the executive directors' particular responsibility on behalf of government to ensure that all assessments are completed expeditiously and truly. Commissioner for Federal Judicial Affairs doesn't take responsibility and even doesn't release the questionnaire, even the answers to the above questions, by the excuse that it is confidential. It is a very important matter, because if a person appointed as a judge with lies, he also doesn't have personal characteristics requirements such as sense of ethics, courtesy, honesty, integrity, reliability, sense of responsibility. I also filed an official complaint in Judicial Council, but they refused to investigate. it. Under Section 63 of Judges Act, Judicial Council have a duty to investigate any complaint. But the system disabled counsel with a complaint review procedure, which I explain it later.